गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम रमन गुप्ता फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज बारा एंड टुडे वील स्टडी वन ऑफ द मेजर पोइट्स ऑफ रोमांटिसिज्म और रोमांटिक एज हुज नेम इज जॉन कीट्स. जॉन कीट्स was born on 31st October 1795 at Moorgate, London in England and was died on 23rd February 1821 at the age of just 25. John Keats was just 25 years when he died, and at this age he had done a great work. He had earned great name in the field of poetry and literature. He was died in Rome, and the death was due to tuberculosis, which was a deadly disease at that time. As we all know that he belonged to romanticism or romantic period. So let's know something about him in detail. Although his poems were not generally well received by critics during his lifetime, his reputation grew after his death, and by the end of 19th century he had become one of the most beloved of all English poets. He had a significant influence on a diverse range of poets and writers. George Luis Borges stated that his first encounter with Keats' work was a great experience that he felt all of his life. The poetry of Keats is characterized by a style heavily loaded with sensualities. The style was different and is known as heavily loaded with sensualities. There was sensuousness in his poetry, most notably in the series of odes. He has written many odes, and it can be noted in these odes. This is typical of the romantic poets, as they aimed to accentuate extreme emotion through an emphasis on natural imagery. Today, his poems and letters are some of the most popular and most analyzed in English literature. Some of his most acclaimed works are Ode to a Nightingale, Sleep and Poetry, and the famous sonnet was On First Looking into Chapman's Homer. The next point is about his biography. We see something about his early life. John Keats was born in Moorgate, London on 31st October 1795 to Thomas Keats and his wife Frances Jennings. So the name of his father was Thomas Keats and mother Frances Jennings. There is little evidence of his exact birthplace, although Keats and his family seem to have marked his birthday on 29th October. Baptism records give the date as the 31st. He was the eldest of four surviving children. His younger siblings were George, Thomas, Frances Mary, whose name is called Fanny, who eventually married Spanish author Valentine
Llanos Gutierrez. Another son was lost in infancy. His father first worked as a hostler at the stables attached to the Swan and Hoop Inn, an establishment he later managed and where the growing family lived for some years. Keats believed that he was born at the inn, a birthplace of humble origins, but there is no evidence to support his belief. The Globe pub now occupies the site a few yards from the modern-day Moorgate station. He was baptized at St. Botolph without Bishopsgate and sent to a local dame school as a child. Now let's see something about his early career. From 1814, Keats had two bequests held in trust for him until his 21st birthday. Pound sterling 800, willed by his grandfather, John Jennings, equivalent to about pound 56,371 in 2019. It seems he was not told of the pound 800 and probably knew nothing of it since he never applied for it. Historically, blame has often been laid on Abbe as legal guardian, but he may also have been unaware. William Walton, solicitor for Keats' mother and grandmother, definitely did not and had a duty of care to relay the information to Keats. It seemed he did not. The money would have made a critical difference to the poet's expectations. Money was always a great concern and difficulty for him, as he struggled to stay out to debt and make his way in the world independently. Yes, now we see about his poetic career. In October 1816, Clark introduced Keats to the influential Leigh Hunt, a close friend of Byron and Shelley. 5 months later came the publication of poems, the first volume of Keats' verse, which included I Stood Tiptoe and Sleep and Poetry, both strongly influenced by Hunt. The book was a critical failure, arousing little interest, although Reynolds reviewed it favorably in The Champion. Clark commented that the book might have emerged in Timbuktu. Keats' publishers, Charles and James Ollier, felt ashamed of the book. Keats immediately changed publishers to Taylor and Hesse on Fleet Street. Unlike the Ollier, Keats' new publishers were enthusiastic about his work. Within a month of the publication of poems, they were planning a new Keats volume and had paid him in advance. Hesse became a steady friend of Keats and made the company's room available for young writers to meet. Their publishing lists eventually included Coleridge, Hazlitt, Clare, Hogg, Carlyle, and Lamb. Though Taylor and Hesse Keats met, their Eton educated lawyer, Richard Woodhouse, who advised them on literary as well as legal matters and was deeply impressed by his poems.
Now, Isabella Jones and Fanny Brown. Keats befriended Isabella Jones in May 1817 while on holiday in the village of Bo Peep near Hastings. She is described as beautiful, talented, and widely read. Not of the top flight of society, yet financially secure. An enigmatic figure who would become a part of Keats' circle. Throughout their friendship, Keats never hesitates to own his sexual attraction to her. Although they seem to enjoy circling each other rather than offering commitment. He writes that he frequented her rooms in the winter of 1818 to 19. And in his letters to George says that he warmed with her and kissed her. The tryst may have been a sexual initiation for Keats according to Bate and Gittings. Jones inspired and was a steward of Keats' writing. The themes of the Eve of St. Agnes and the Eve of St. Mark may well have been suggested by her. The lyric "Hush, hush, O sweet Isabel" was about her, and that the first version of "Bright Star" may have originally been for her. Jones was one of the first in England to be notified of Keats' death. Letters and drafts of poems suggested that Keats first met Frances or Fanny Brown between September and November. Her name was Frances Brown or Fanny Brown. It is likely that the 18 years old Brown visited the Dalke family at Wentworth Place before she lived there. She was born in the hamlet of West End, now in the district of West Hampstead, on 9th August 1800. Like Keats' grandfather, her grandfather kept a London inn, and both lost several family members to tuberculosis. She shared her first name with both Keats' sister and mother, and had a talent for dressmaking and languages, as well as a natural theatrical bent. During November 1818, she developed an intimacy with Keats, but it was shadowed by the illness of Tom Keats, whom Jones was nursing through this period. Tuberculosis took hold, and he was advised by his doctors to move to a warmer climate when he was in the grip of deadly disease, tuberculosis. Doctors advised him to live in a warmer climate because the climate of London and England is too cold. In September 1820, Keats left for Rome, knowing that he would probably never see Brown again. After leaving, he felt unable to write to her or read her letters, although he did correspond with her mother. He died there 5 months later. None of Brown's letters to Keats survive. It took a month for the news of his death to reach London, after which Brown stayed in mourning for 6 years. In 1833, more than 12 years after his death, she married and went on to have 3 children. She outlived Keats by more than 40 years. So this was the end of John Keats' life.
Now let's see, let's have a look on his major works. As you all know that John Keats is very important in Romanticism. The most important works of Keats are these are the articles written on him. So we have read already that the important works of John Keats are Looking into Chapman's Homer and Cox, Jeffrey N. edited as Keats Poetry and Prose, New York and London. These are the research articles written on John Keats, in which they have studied about John Keats and his life, his poetry, his works, all these. I think at this time you don't need to study all these articles, but you are to study only the literary works of John Keats. So thank you and have a nice day. We'll study next topic in the next video.